A very good morning to all of you. This is Abhilasha Nahata, your social science teacher, and today we are going to discuss continue our chapter 1 of your geography book, that is resources. So in our last class we discussed about the types of resources. So resources are generally classified into natural resources, human made resources, and human resources. And in our last class we discussed about natural resources. So natural resources, something resources that are drawn from nature, is known as natural resources, and we can use it without doing much modifications to it. And it is also considered as the free gifts of nature, because nature is providing all those resources to us, and we are able to use that resources as per our needs. And if we want to do any kind of modification, we can do it. Okay, so after that we talked about the classification of natural resources. So we classified, or you can say natural resources are classified into different groups, and depending upon their nature. So on the basis of their development or use, we classified natural resources into actual resources and potential resources. Actual resources are those resources whose quantity is known, and potential resources are those resources whose entire quantity may not be known to us. And after that we classified natural resources on the basis of origin. Okay, from where did it originated? So it on the basis of origin, biotic and abiotic components, or you can say biotic resources, abiotic resources. So all the living things come, and all the living things are abiotic, biotic resources, and all the non-living things are abiotic resources. So again, once again, sorry, there is a mistake. Okay, here it is abiotic. And after that, we divided it on the basis of stock. So on the basis of stock, it is divided into renewable resources and non-renewable resources. So renewable resources, which are those resources which can be renewed or replenished quickly, are known as renewable resources. For example, we use solar energy, wind energy as much as we want to do it. Okay, and there are some resources whose quantity which have limited in stock, whose quantity is like so limited. Okay, and once it got used, it may take so much time to renew it, and it take so much time to get that resource back to us. So like millions or thousands of years of times we required to get those resources renewed or replenished. Okay, so after that these are some of the examples of renewable and non-renewable energy. And after that we divided the natural resources on the basis of distribution. So on the basis of distribution, resources are classified as ubiquitous resources and localized resources. Ubiquitous resources, those resources which are found everywhere on the earth. For example, air, water, land. These are the resources which we found everywhere on the earth. Either we are in Antarctica, or we are in India, or we are in Russia. Air is everywhere. Water in different forms, yes, available there. Okay, but some resources are there which found only in specific places or certain places. For example, coal, petroleum. We don't gold, or you can say different types of metals. These resources found only in certain places. Okay, take an example of coal. In India, we get coal in the areas of like Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, or you can say some parts of Madhya Pradesh. We got coal there. We get coal. If we want to get coal, we can get coal from there. Okay, but if we want coal in Rajasthan, we don't find coal here, right? So ubiquitous resources, those resources which we found everywhere on the earth, example air, water, land, and localized resources which are found only in certain places or specific places are known as localized resources. Coal, copper, iron, these are some of the examples of the localized resources. Now we will move further to our next type of resource, that is human made resources. Okay, so human made resources, what are human made resources? Or the another name for human made resource is man made resources. Okay, the resources which are created from natural resources by the human beings to produce useful products are known as human made resources. Those resources or those natural resources which we as a human being modify into useful products are known as human made resources. For example, there are some examples which you all are able to see on your screen. Roads. Okay, roads constructed by, just look at this person, just look at this man, he is constructing roads. Okay, but the resources which are required to make roads are, we are getting those resources from nature, but those resources that the products which we require to make the roads are modifying by humans. Okay, and we by using those resources, humans are constructing roads. So next example, take an example of cars. So many different metals or machines, and after combining it, humans are making cars. Okay, so cars is also created by human beings and it is very useful product. Bridges, okay, to connect places, we are also making bridges from, we are making bridges from wood, we are making bridges from iron or steel. Okay, so who created these bridges? Created by human beings only. Buildings, okay, we use different materials, bricks, steel, iron, wood, etc., to make a building, right? And who created these buildings? It is created by human. Okay, so those resources which are created from the natural resources by the human beings to produce useful products are known as human made resources. Aise resources jo human beings kya karte hain, banate hain यूजफुल प्रोडक्ट, ठीक है, नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज का यूज करते हुए उसे यूजफुल प्रोडक्ट में कन्वर्ट करते हैं, पर मेन रोल यहाँ पे ह्यूमन बींग्स का होता है, तो इसलिए हम ह्यूमन मेड रिसोर्स बोलते हैं या फिर हम इसे मैन मेड रिसोर्स भी बोलते हैं. ओके, सो नाउ देयर इज एन एक्टिविटी फॉर यू गाइज. So take 2 minutes and make a list of 5 human made resources that you can observe around you. You have to write 5 human made resources that you observe around you. आप जो अपने आसपास 5 चीजें देख रहे हो, कोई भी 5 चीजें लिखो जो आप अपने आसपास क्या है देखते हो, जो humans ने बनाई हुई है. जैसे अगर मैं example दूं तो मेरे सामने है laptop, ये कंप्यूटर है, तो कंप्यूटर किसने बनाया है? इट इज मेड बाय ह्यूमन बीइंग. सो आई गिव यू द एग्जांपल ऑफ कंप्यूटर, मोबाइल फोन, दीज आर द टू एग्जांपल्स फ्रॉम माय साइड. नाउ इट इज योर टाइम टू राइट डाउन 5 रिसोर्सेज मेड बाय ह्यूमन. ओके, और यू कैन से 5 एग्जांपल्स ऑफ ह्यूमन मेड रिसोर्सेज. सो Next resource is human resource. Okay, so what are human resources? Human resources refer to the number, or you can say quantity, and abilities. Abilities, it is mentally or physically. Some people are very good physically. They are very good in sports. But some students or some persons are like God gifted, or you can say intelligent. ठीक है, they have a very good catching power, strong language power. So mental, they have very good ideas. So some students or persons have physical abilities and mental abilities. Okay, so human resources refers to the number and abilities of the people. People can make the best use of nature to create more resources when they have the knowledge, skill, and the technology. So in human made resources, we talked about roads, bags, tables. These are some of the human made examples of human made resources. But without the idea of making it or converting natural resources into a useful product, is it possible for us to use that resource? एक नॉलेज होनी चाहिए ना. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू से अगर मैं आपको बोलूं कि मेक अ लैपटॉप, आप बना सकते हो लैपटॉप? यू आर एबल टू मेक दैट लैपटॉप? At present, no, because you have not developed that skill yet. Okay, आपके अंदर वो skill नहीं है अभी laptop बनाने वाली. आपको नहीं पता what resources we require to make laptops, right? So without knowledge, without skill, or you can say without technology, we can't make human made resources. Okay, so human resources basically जो people है उन्हीं को human resources बोला गया है. The abilities, the skills, the knowledge of persons or people is known as human resources. Okay, so human resources refer to the number, quantity, and abilities, either mentally or physically, of the people. People can make the best use of nature to create more resources when they have the knowledge, skill, and the technology. Now, just like Shivanya asked me right now, ma'am, food comes under natural resource or human made resource? So it depends. Nature provide us food. Okay, nature provide us wheat or rice. We as a human being, we have the skill to convert that rice into dosa. Okay, agar theek hai, most of you guys are like teenager. Okay, you don't know how to cook. Most of you guys don't know how to cook. In this stage, we don't know how to make perfect dosa or something like that. Maybe most of you know, but at your age, I was not aware about how to cook dosas and idlis. Okay, so just like Shamanya asked me, ma'am, dosa jo hai ya food jo hai, kis mein, kaun se resource mein aayega? Human made mein aayega ki natural mein aayega? Nature provide us rice. Okay, nature is a rice is a natural resources, but with our skill, with the knowledge of converting it into dosa, okay, we made it human made resource. So human resource, what is human resource? Ability or knowledge or skill of the people. So people itself is known as human resources. Just look at this this clip art. Just look at this. Here is a person. Take care. He is using at his laptop, and he came up with an idea, maybe some kind of idea. Okay, we meet people, we make statistics, we make charts, we announce things. Okay, so there are certain kinds, there are so many persons who come up with different ideas. Okay, so you all are the valuable resources of our time. Okay, of future, you are most valuable, and you are the human resources. We are the human resources who come up with different ideas to convert natural resources into useful products with our knowledge and skill. So we all are studying. You all come to school, or right now not physically, but yes, you all are coming to school and getting knowledge from your teachers, from different books. And why are you getting these knowledge, or why are you studying? To develop your knowledge, to develop your skill, and convert that skill into useful resource further, right? So you all are human resources. We are human resources. So now, class, just look at this example. So it is given in your book only. So here, what happens? You crops ruined due to drought. Can I find a solution? Now she is a scientist, and she is like, she got the news ki jo crops hain sukha, drought means sukha pad jana. Sukhne ke wajah se kya hua hai, puri jo crops hai wo ruin ho chuki hai. So now she is thinking, can I find a solution? What can I do? So okay, with her skill, with so many explorations, came up with an idea, and she said, that's it. So it's all thanks to the knowledge and education and skill we could find a solution. With knowledge, with education, with skill, we could find a solution. For example, last year coronavirus COVID-19 situation aayi hamare world mein. Okay, so various scientists were working on it, and they are right now in present also they are working on it. Okay, ki hum kaise vaccine banaye, bahut time laga unko vaccine banane mein, but with their knowledge, with the education they have, with the skill they have, they came up with the solution. They made the vaccine, right? So just like that, farmers also feel so good jab ye jo scientist hain ye ek apne knowledge, apne education aur skill ke wajah se kya hai ki crops ruined ho chuki hai, to main hum ise kaise sahi kar sakte hain, uske liye ek solution leke aayi. Theek hai, so we as human beings, all human beings are directly or indirectly interdependent on each others. For example, farmers, we all are dependent on farmers for our food, right? We all are farmers provide us food grains, and scientists suggest various means to combat problems, and how scientists are providing help to them, like farmers were facing problems of getting their crops ruined due to drought. So that scientist helped them to find a solution, to combat with that solution. Okay. So we would say, directly or indirectly, we all are dependent and interdependent on each other. So human resource development, what is human resource development? Improving the quality of people's skills so that they are able to create more resources is known as human resource development. So we all are studying, so we all are improving our quality, improving our skills. To improve our quality, we all do certain types of trainings. Like for examples, for teachers also, there are certain kinds of trainings. Why? To improve their quality, of giving or spreading knowledge, right? So improving the quality of people's skills so that they are able to create more resources, more useful resources, is known as human resource development. And education and health help in making people a valuable resources. Valuable means worthy. Okay, education and healthy. If a person is healthy, he is able to get or improve his or her quality, his or her skill. ओके अगर आप हेल्दी नहीं हो तो आप कोई भी काम अच्छे से नहीं कर सकते हो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ़ यू गॉट फीवर और आपकी मदर बोले कि आप जाके खेलो ठीक है या फिर आप जाके पढ़ाई करो, यू कॉन्ट डू एट दैट टाइम. आप बोलोगे मम्मा मेरे को मेरे बॉडी में बिल्कुल भी क्या है मेरे में स्ट्रेंथ नहीं है कि मैं उठ भी सकूँ ठीक है, मैं ये काम नहीं कर पाऊंगा. So this is the example. If we are healthy, we will give our best. So education and health help in making people a valuable resources. Okay. So sorry. This is all about today class. Thank you for joining the class. If you face any problem, you all may ask me in my next class. Thank you everybody. Bye bye. Take care of yourself and please stay at home.